higher by 3 kilometers. Now we finally reach here. This is the way of source the mail, and from here 4 kilometers. Yes, we go direct. Park first the car somewhere, and thank you Patrick,
yeah,
for being here with us.
Yeah, to the tourism site. So yeah, we
very nice.
We start with the source of Nile.
Very nice
down
time,
there.
I think.
Then we go to the picnic area up there.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah.
So wish you all the best. You can. Thank you so much. Eh? So finally we are here in source of the Nile. This is the southern most source of Nile River, and it is in Burundar. One is the White Nile. So this is the White Nile source, origin source, and we are going to show very soon. And you are going to see the source of Nile there. We are just going with guide. We are waiting for here. Our car is here. Our guide is here. And we are going to explore each and every thing, whatever the good thing in Burundi. So slowly, slowly, we are heading to that area. But we have to wait for a moment. Then we move. This is our guide. They are going to guide us, and they are going to explain the history about source of the Nile. Is there any board so I can explain? And this is the landscape you can see. And today weather is too good, so I will be there within few minutes. So be in blog, don't go anywhere. Thank you so much. Mujhe hi goja ki dogo. We are going together. We have many guy. If someone is left, it's not good. Patrick, ingo tara tayari haraka.
Hey, yes, see. Hello, see.
Okay. So this is our guide. Nisawa papa.
Nisawa.
Rakome.
Rakome.
So this is the gate we are going to enter. Buke.
Welcome.
Thank you. Please.
Hello.
Where is Irina? Irina is coming. Fast, Irina. So explain about something of this beautiful place,
and yeah, we are going to. Now we are going down to actually the source of the water.
Welcome.
Yes. Thank you.
And from there we see the guide cannot tell you more about
so
it.
Where the water came from? Because here is no mountain. Uh-huh. Nothing is here. So where the mountain, the maji, the water came from?
Yeah, from inside the earth.
From inside.
Yes, from the earth.
Oh yeah.
What do you mean there is no mountain? It is a mountain.
It is already
a mountain, eh? Okay, please proceed. But this place is not looking like a mountain, eh? We just came. We did not hike anything.
Because we came. Can you imagine if we were walking? You'll see that's the real mountain.
yes.
No, actually it's called a hill, not like mountain.
Not yeah, this is
yes,
the hill.
Like a hill, but still.
But yeah. And that person. Wow. He discovered this place where the water came from. It is not easy.
Yes.
At that time,
man, this
he spent 4 years to come all the way from Egypt.
Not four, I guess.
Six,
it was 5 or 6 years.
He came from Egypt.
Let's ask the guide.
Okay.
He knows better.
But guide cannot explain in English.
No.
But someone have to.
Yes, Patrick. Patrick will
help us.
Translation.
Eh? Okay. So this is the source of Nile. You can see.
So Patrick, you have to translate.
Yes, Patrick.
I think the last time we were here, there was no translation.
No translation. Yeah. Sometimes.
So you did not get.
So we can go with nearby.
There is a lot of kids. I don't know.
Everyone is taking selfie. Yeah. This is the selfie time. Oh my god, it's too clean. The water is too clean.
So they say the water is clean, you can drink it, it's nice.
And since 24 hours it's coming.
Yeah.
Same.
Yeah,
same frequency.
Yeah. So it's just the same.
So Mujay, you can start explaining, then Mr. Patrick is going to convert in English.
Yeah.
Because we sometimes don't know Swahili Kurundi problem.
Okay. So he's saying welcome to everyone.
Thank you so much, thank you. Welcome to Burundi, Kaze Burundi.
Yeah, his name is Nahimana Herma.
Okay.
And he's our guide.
Okay.
He's going to explain the history about this place.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
And I'm going to show you avant de raconter l'histoire, I'm going to orient you.
Yeah, before telling the story, he would like to give us the geographic location where we are right now.
Okay. We're in some au sud est du pays.
We are in the southeast of the country.
Okay.
Some are 150 kilometers from the capital of Bujumbura.
And it's 150 kilometers from Bujumbura.
Yes.
Some dans la province qu'on appelle Burundi.
Yeah, this is Burundi province.
Yes.
And we're talking about Burundi. A commune of Rutovu.
And the commune of Rutovu. So this is a mount which is called Gikizi.
Gikizi. Yes.
At an altitude 2100 meters.
And it's the altitude is 2100 meters.
2100 meters.
Yeah.
Tu calcules qu'il y a la crête Congo Nil. Ça veut dire la crête qui sépare deux bassins. Bassin du Nil, bassin du Congo.
Yeah, so we are on the ridge which separates the basin of rivers going to the Nile and the rivers going to the Congo River.
Okay.
À partir de Somme vers le nord jusqu'à la Méditerranée, il y a trois bassins du Nil.
Yeah, so from here to the Mediterranean Sea, it is called the Nile Basin, from Burundi all the way.
Okay, au sud de cette carte vers le sud, c'est le bassin du Congo.
Yeah, so when you go to the south, it will be called the Congo Basin.
Okay. Cela veut dire que toutes les rivières et ses affluents au sud de cette crête se viennent d'abord dans le lac Tanganyika, le fleuve Congo, qui vient d'appuyer versement l'océan Atlantique.
So from the other side, when you go to the west,
okay,
all the river we go into Tanganyika,
yes,
then from Tanganyika into Congo River,
okay,
and from Congo River into the Atlantic Ocean.
Tandis que l'eau qui sort vers le nord va à la Méditerranée.
Yeah, so all those going to the Nile Basin, they go to the Mediterranean Sea.
Bon, la crête alors constitue la ligne de partage des eaux.
So the ridge separates the two basins, The one going to the Nile Basin and the
other is going to Congo.
Okay, au nord, la Méditerranée, au sud, l'Atlantique.
Yeah. In the north, the Mediterranean, in the south, the Atlantic.
Okay.
Okay. Go. Comment orientation alors?
So, now about the orientation.
Yes. C'était en 1930.
Yeah. So, it was in 1930.
Un certain Allemand du nom de Dr. Burkhard Waldbach.
Also an explorer.
Dr. Burkhard.
Original from Norman.
Burkhard. Bon, lorsqu'il était en Égypte sur la mer Méditerranée, voyant le Nil se jetant dans la mer Méditerranée, il s'est posé la question de vous essayer.
So when he saw how the Nile was going to the Mediterranean, while he was still in Egypt, he was asking himself the question about where is the source?
Where is the source of the Nile? This is White Nile.
Yeah.
White Nile.
Bon. Où est-ce qu'il était en Égypte? Il était sur le lac Bita, Kil Bahar El Abiad Nil. C'est arabe. En français, veut dire la mer blanche du Nil.
Okay, so he was near the lake called the
Kil Bahar El
Kir Bahar
Nil.
Okay. Oh, yeah. It's too difficult. Okay, whatever he said, that one.
Voilà, il a quitté l'Égypte, il s'est rendu en Éthiopie, plutôt au Soudan du Nord.
So he left Egypt and went to
Sudan.
Où il a rencontré le lac qu'on appelle Khan Nikira Bahar El Jebel.
So in Sudan he went to the lake called Bahar El Jebel.
Ça veut dire en français la mer de la montagne.
So it's the sea, let's say the sea mountain or the lake in the mountain.
Okay. Et voilà, il a avancé vers le Soudan du Sud où il a rencontré le lac Albert ou Mwitazibe, parce que le lac Albert passe par trois pays, entre le Congo, l'Ouganda et le Soudan du Sud.
So he went to the Sudan, South Sudan, when he found the Lake Albert,
Mwitazibe.
Yes. So it's a lake which separates three countries, Sudan, Uganda and Congo.
Voilà, avancé vers l'Ouganda, il a rencontré le lac qu'on appelle Kiyoga et le Victoria Nil en Ouganda.
So he moved to Uganda where he found another lake called Kiyoga.
Voilà. Avancé vers la Tanzanie.
Then he moved again to Tanzania.
Il a rencontré le lac qu'on appelle Victoria.
So he found the lake Victoria.
That is the biggest lake in the world.
So he moved then to Rwanda where he found the river Akagera.
Voilà. Maintenant, il rentre au Burundi, du nord du Burundi, dans la province qu'on appelle Moyinga, où il a rencontré la rivière qu'on appelle Ruvuvu.
So he entered in Burundi in the north, in Moyinga, where he found the Ruvuvu River.
Ruvuvu River, yes.
Voilà, il descend au centre du pays, à Gitega, à partir de Mugera jusqu'à Mawa, c'est à 15 km d'ici.
So from Mugera, he was already inside Burundi, yes. And Mawa, which is 50 kilometers from here, he found a river called Ruvuvu.
Voilà. Yes. Avancé vers ici, à 5 km d'ici, il a rencontré la rivière qu'on appelle Kigira.
So, 5 km from here, he found a river called Kigira.
Kigira.
Voilà, à 2 km d'ici, sur le pont, ça s'appelle Kasenyi.
And there is a bridge at 2 km from here, which the river is called Kasenyi.
Voilà, arrivé ici.
And he arrived here.
Yes.
So it's near the tree that you see there.
This tree. L'arbre orapel araucaria, le nom scientifique de l'arbre.
So that tree is called araucaria. It's okay. A scientific name.
Yes.
Voilà,
yes.
Il a trouvé une fontaine d'eau là-bas, un petit jaillissement d'eau. Il a canalisé l'eau là-bas.
So he found a fountain of water that place.
It's coming from inside.
Protected it. Yeah.
Yes.
L'Allemand ne devait pas de passer là pour aller chercher la source de l'eau cette mandat. Il aurait entré dans un autre bassin.
So if he went beyond that part, he would find himself in the new basin, the Congo basin.
Okay,
so that's
okay.
Why he stopped
here. He stopped here, eh?
Voilà, alors l'Allemand vient de découvrir la source la plus méridionale du Nil à côté de la route de Bouel.
So that's how he found the southernmost source of Nile.
Southernmost source of White Nile.
Voilà. Yes. Voilà, après une longue marche.
So it's